Hi everybody, welcome back. Tim Schneider with Aegis Learning as we begin our journey talking about building and managing our own resilience. As you remember from last time, resilience is defined as that ability to bounce back, to recover quickly from any setback or obstacle, and we know that those setbacks and obstacles are going to occur. Now the very first strategy today is all wrapped around the connectivity between our mind, our emotion, and our bodies. And the first strategy of dealing with resiliency is to take care of your body. I mean, quite simply, we're not going to be able to respond and recover if this vessel that we live in, that we occupy, isn't in really kind of pretty good shape. And that includes things like diet, exercise, rest, and what we choose to put into our body as well. A little different from diet. But you know what? A lot of folks do a great, great job of managing their diet, much better than I do, certainly. And a lot of people do a great job of getting regular, recurring exercise and, you know, kind of take care of their cardiovascular and their muscular and their skeletal system. But the one that is most commonly drawn from and that we really don't pay as close attention to as we should is the rest piece. This is a case where I'm going to encourage you to really listen to your body and don't try to do the binge thing where you scrimp all week long on it and you only get a handful of hours of it and then on the weekend you try to kind of binge and catch up. That's not going to work. This is about creating balance. And there is no perfect magic number. You know, for years there have been things written about 8 hours or 7 hours or 9 hours, whatever. You know what? There is no magic number. Listen to your body. If you're tired, if you're yawning, if you can't keep your eyes open, get some rest, get some good uninterrupted sleep. And then one final part of taking care of this as it relates to resilience is be careful what we put into it. Resilience can be impacted pretty dramatically by overuse of alcohol, drugs, even prescription drugs. It can be impacted by the use of nicotine, me, the use of the overuse of caffeine, me also. But we've got to be careful about that because all of those have a dragging effect on our resilience. So learn in all of those cases some moderation. Moderation will serve you incredibly well. You don't have to dump all the fun stuff in life, to build resilience. But what we have to do is just pay attention to doing it in a nice, easy, moderate way. And again, listen to your body about the rest piece. All right, next week we have another great tactic and strategy for dealing with resilience. I look forward to talking to you then. Have a great week, everybody. We'll be right back.